I would like all of you to please join me in welcoming Mr. Sunil Kataria, CEO India and SAARC, Godrej Consumer Products Limited, who will tell us the journey of Good Night.
First of all, thank you, Anurag and Exchange for Media team, for having me over for this conversation with all of you. And thank you all of you for making it in this crazy traffic jams. It took me more than an hour, while I thought I'll take 35 minutes for something nearby. And I think I'm roughly around 25 to 30 minutes. And this is a long journey. I can't cover 3 decades of Good Night brand journey in 30 minutes. No amount of technology can help me do that. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll take snippets out of it. I've tried to carve this into some very broad macro buckets, and I've tried to pick up some very big themes that have crafted this brand. Because I think while there's obviously a huge amount of technology which is disrupting us, and I'm a true believer of the fact that we are living in transformational times. While that seems a very cliched word, but I know the struggles as a CEO I'm facing in, you know, navigating the business in such truly crazy times. But at the same time, I can tell you, while these technologies obviously making us unlearn so much in terms of the way consumers interact with the brands, in the way consumers consume media, in the way they consume content, everything is changing. But I believe in any such VUCA times, while that's a different topic as to how to navigate yours, the organization during that time, there's certain things will not change. And I think that's the part which I'm going to talk about, some basic principles of marketing and branding which will remain strong, which in fact need to be, you know, over-invested in, and obviously how they get executed, how they interface with the brand, with consumers, all that is going to change. Technology is dictating that. But there are some principles, some pillars, which I think remain the same. And actually that consistency, to my message, that consistency is going to be the most important one. So let me straight away jump into this next 30 minutes or so. 3 decades of happiness is what I'm calling this whole journey. So before I just, maybe 2-3 minutes on this category, the household insecticide category, what this is it, so that you can get an idea of some constraints and some you know, challenges of this category. So first of all, this is very interesting data. Mosquitoes have killed more people than all walls combined since 1400 AD, the history is tracked. You know. So this is the biggest killer, not coronavirus, not the wars which have been fought, and we hear so much of wars happening all over, but this is a very interesting fact that this is one, you know, living thing in the world which is one of the biggest killers. And it's across the world. Some countries have conquered it, some countries have obviously eliminated it. Elimination is very difficult right now, but yeah, some have really, I think, taken charge, and there's some which are really struggling. It's this category, roughly a $900 million category. That's one size you need to be aware of. The rest is all material. And the last fact is, in India, roughly the penetration of this category is around 60-odd%. Which is in urban around 75, and in rural roughly around 40. So there is still a headroom to grow in this category after 3 years of, 3 decades of work in primarily rural and little bit in urban as well. But yeah, that's it. But at the same time, as marketeers, you know what does penetration mean. It is one product, one consumption in a year, which hardly has any meaning, you know, beyond a point. So let me just sum to the Good Night journey. Before I start, I think this is something I don't want to give you too much of gyan on this. This is all you know, but I want to reinforce this. As I said, in this changing world, 3 things which I think define great brands, and I think even after 30 years from now, which will continue to define great brands, I think are 3 principles. Their mode of execution, their mode of transference may change, but these principles, I think, are going to be more true than ever. So first and foremost is the brand which will succeed will have to have deep consumer connect. Obviously, the way of connecting will be different, you know, which is building brand love and engagement. Second, I think what we call, which is true of this brand, I'm going to talk to you all these 3 pieces of Good Night, really. Today, my whole talk about these 3 pieces, how this brand has navigated itself. Great brands have one lighthouse identity. They stay true to one essence. Obviously, over 30 years, that essence evolves. It cannot remain constant. It cannot remain, you know, static. But yeah, it has to evolve, but it can't suddenly deviate too much unless until you are realizing certain fundamental of your brand codes, or maybe if you have fundamentally gone wrong in your essence itself, then you change it. But once you think you have arrived at a place where you want to be, you stray to that and you evolve it with times. And the last piece is, which I think is very, very critical, and this is a piece which is changing the most, I think, in today's digital world, where online brands are breaking a lot of barriers which exist in conventional CPG world, is, in fact, one word I should have put it here, is relentless innovation focus. And this is an important piece which I tell my teams, you know, that many times in marketing when we joined, when we started marketing and all sales, all of us heard consumer is king. Consumer connect is the most important, which all I agree. But you know, there's one piece which in innovation we have to realize, and this is something which is another favorite topic of mine on how we do researches and how do we try to pick consumer insights. You need to listen to your consumer. But consumers can never ever drive your innovation journey, because consumers can never think the future. Consumers can also tell you about what they feel today, right? That's it. So listen to consumers, but great brands have to think ahead of consumers. Only then will great innovation happen. So that, I think, is a very important distinction which great brands do. You can't tell, let consumer tell you what product they want. They will never be able to tell you what product they want. And the fact is, this consistency is becoming more and more important. So now the Goodnight journey, I was trying to see how this phase is, can be split. I broadly split it into three. Obviously, in retrospect, it looks nice to put it. But when I see broad themes which emerged in this brand's journey over here, I would put it into three decades. The first decade is 1980 to 84, when this brand took shape, a birth. The first decade was 84 to 94, when it was a niche entrant. This brand, when it started playing a true category disruptor role, the second decade of 95 to 2006, and then the 2000 onwards, which is more than a decade now, is the brand when it started, it became a leader, it became an omni leader, and I explained that, and it became a category creator. One thing, interesting piece is, this is the phase when this brand, the first one, when 84 to 94 it happened. This brand actually was never, it was not a Godrej brand. It was a brand which was launched by a company called Trans-Electra, which launched electric formats. I'll tell you that journey a little bit quickly. And in 94, this brand got acquired by Godrej. In fact, we today celebrate 25 years of Goodnight exactly in 2019 of it being part of the Godrej portfolio. So the last two decades, 25 years has been the Godrej journey, which obviously is taken. But I can tell you some of these pillars with full, I think, credit to the teams which actually gave birth to it. And we know some of those people, I know personally, who created this brand. I think there were some pillars, while they may not have been true marketeers, conventional MBAs, but I guess some of the pillars they crafted very clearly in their mind. I think obviously as it came to Godrej, it took a very different size, shape, momentum, but I think those pillars by and large, we've been true to that. So the first one, in fact, interestingly, we see the Goodnight logo has evolved over the period of time. All the three decades, it's a different logo, it's changed. Okay, so this one, so I'll just now talk about each of the three things in a very clear three slides. And then what I'm going to do is, I think the best journey can be communicated through the communication. I've got a hell of a lot of ads, and I'll see how many I can show you, which really define what worked. Obviously, this doesn't explain the full story. I think what I'm doing is I'm picking up some epic ads, which I think which communicate to this audience here, what are the direction the brand took and how it came alive in terms of its innovation, in terms of its connect, in terms of its essence with consumers. Obviously, there are many other things which happened in between, many mini innovations which have happened, many micro-segmentation initiatives which happened, which obviously cannot be covered right now. So the first piece is the three pillars. In the first decade, the deep consumer connect, the category insight at that time was in 84 to 94, this country was never bothered about vector-borne diseases. We didn't know what is dengue in this country. Chikungunya was never heard of, right? And even sensitivity at that time, this was almost a pre-liberalization period, you know. We didn't have any color televisions. It was more a subsistence kind of, sustenance kind of economy, right? And by and large, people were more bothered and mosquitoes were seen as irritants who spoil sleep. It was never about diseases. There was no fear or anxiety around mosquitoes. It was by and large a nuisance value. And that's the category insight which, and by that time, there were these tortoise coils and all those you may have heard of. I don't know many of you heard, there was Kachua Chap coil. I guess all those were there. India also used to be hell of a lot of unbranded at that time. People would move around this, you know, neem leaves, tulsi leaves in their homes, and they'll just burn that, and smoke itself will drive away mosquitoes. That was the biology of the country, the way it used to happen. Or they will just simply shut the windows in the night, and that's what happened, right? So this is a category inside which this company, Trans-Electra, when they gave birth to this brand, they picked up. And there was one thing which was happening. There were a couple of other brands which had come in, which were like Tortoise or other brands. All brands were doing one thing, and this is the lighthouse identity of Goodnight you will see has remained constant throughout the decades, that all brands were talking about killing mosquitoes, you know. And that was a very clear, and if you see even today, that's the code of most of the brands in this category. Goodnight right at the beginning built a, took a connect at the consumer level. They said, okay, instead of talking killing mosquitoes, we'll talk about giving a good night's sleep. In fact, that's, I think this brand name itself is brilliantly crafted. with the way it's, the night has two meanings, you know, protection as well as night sleep, you know, right? So I think that's the big shift this brand started with. And that, I think, is the big first connect that you see which came about. This gave birth to the lighthouse identity. And unlike competition, good night of the brand, and you can go back and check even today, all the advertising of all players in this category, they focus on the harshness and the efficacy of the product. On harshness of the issue and the efficacy of the product. It's all about me versus mosquitoes and how I can kill them. This brand decided to focus only on one area of called, we are about caring and protection of the family. And the second essence which took shape is that product innovator to this country would be good night. And I think this is a lighthouse identity, these two pillars which have remained constant across three decades. The first decade led to this company, this brand started with India's first electric mat solution in this country. India had never seen an electric solution. I don't know how many of you in your times would have stayed in hostels and burned those mats even with, you know, as a burning instead of machines, you know. So the first electrical solution to this country was in the form of mat, which was the birth of Goodnight, the brand. So that happened in 84. And then after 6 years, it created another electric solution called Liquidator. So this decade was the electrical solutions year with which this company came to be known. And this was also called a Trans Electra as a company, you know. Incidentally, one thing I want to tell you why I'm going to talk a lot about innovation focus of this brand. There is one big regulatory challenge with this category faces. You are all marketeers who turn around innovation cycles in 6 months, 10 months, 12 months. All regulatory, all insecticide products in this country are regulated because they have actives inside it. And those actives are made by two big companies in the world. One is Bayer and one is Sumitomo. They are the ones who create molecules which can repel or kill mosquitoes. Those are not actually in our hands. They are global researches which are done by these large companies. So A, you are dependent on the molecules which are being evolved globally by these two international companies. Secondly, once those, and those molecules will take five years to evolve, you know, and you depend on their global billions of dollars researches. Once those molecules are even ready, and this is an important piece to say how a brand can come up with innovation in this, then the work of the companies which are insecticide companies takes over, that how do you, your R&D picks up those molecules, convert them into actives and mediums and products based on hell of a lot of R&D work and testing which happens. Now, once your own R&Ds have created this product over 2 years, in India, there is a board called Insecticide Board of India, which is under the Ministry of Agriculture, because these molecules have to be safe, to be used in 100% safe. And at a company like Godrej, we obviously have a huge amount of trust. We don't let anything go which is not clear. The CIB, or the Insecticide Board of India, do their own testing of each product that we supply to them. And that testing takes anywhere between 2 to 3 years. They have whole committees which keep on asking you for this data, that data, multiple stages. They can reject things. So anyway, a product in this category, if you're really wanting to be a true innovator, is at least a 4-year to 5-year game. You can crunch it to 3 by being very agile. And this is after the molecules have been there globally. And how do you convert those molecules? So that's the one challenge. It's not, you know, we are also into soaps. We are also into personal care. Those are much simpler innovation cycles. This is a very different innovation skill. This is the advantage also of this. Once you have created a disruptor, you also have an entry barrier. That somebody else, before they copy you easily, you will get at least a 18-month to 20-month lead time, you know. So these two formats happened in that decade. I was trying to dig out dates. One ad didn't work, so I'll show you one very old ad of the electric format. Suresh Oberoi was the guy they were used at the time, Vivek Oberoi's father. So this advertising.
No fumes.
No ash.
No beam. No mosquitoes either. For his good night. Good night. Good night.
Good night. So easy to use. Insert a good night mat, plug in and switch on. Freedom from mosquitoes.
Sweet dreams and good night, folks. Sweet dreams and good night, folks. Good night, folks.
Did you notice one thing in this ad, which we don't do today, actually? It is an ad in English, right? Because this is such a premium product at that time, the 84 of India, that people were, by and large, into coils or burnings. It is a very premium product. So the advertising was in English, and it went only on very, very niche channels, etc. You know, so that's a very neat thing, which I was obviously not there. I mean, I also related, I said, this is English advertising, you know, at that time, which happened, you know. Then obviously, I do not have the advertising, the Liquidator right now, so I'll skip that. Then, this is a bit, so basically, if I were to define, I think this is a summary of the first decade, broadly, as an entrant. You have premier niche entrant, there are mass of coils all around these, you know, and some of them were unregulated products, some of them not, didn't even have actives, you know. Do you know this tortoise, kachwacha coil, actually had no active into it. It was repelling mosquitoes only by smoke. That's it, it had no active. The first product which came with active was this electrical mat. You know, it didn't have actives. Because these companies didn't have, money to do such expensive R&D and research, you know. So these two big innovations happened on the electrical side, the premium end. The lighthouse identity got created. And these two themes you will see are consistent. Care protection for the family, not about harshness, and product innovation. And obviously, this was this thing. Now quickly, I'll move to the second because this gets interesting and there's more work I want to show you quickly. This decade, I think, truly made Goodnight what it is today. I think this is a defining decade, I would say, if I reflect back, when Godrej took over this brand. It had the might of Godrej, the resources of Godrej, and they looked at this brand pretty differently. This is when it started disrupting the category, or thinking, okay, what will I do? There were obviously a couple of other innovations that happened in this category by the time Godrej took over, and said, now I want to take over. There's a brand which had happened in between, which had done one disruption, which Goodnight actually had missed out, was All Out, with a brand at that time by a company called Karamchand. It was not Asian, it was a brand called Karamchand. And they had tied up with some Japanese company and they had come up with this, I don't know how much of you remember this, they had this machine eating mosquitoes, you know. So it was all about killing mosquitoes, you know. So then Godrej took this brand. The one category insight in this decade which evolved and brought in the decade which mega insight would change in the categories, consumers started feeling that mosquitoes are becoming stubborn and tougher. Then now they're becoming immune to whatever I do. Little bit. That, you know, things that we started picking up in this decade. Secondly, the consumer anxiety started moving away from nuisance and irritation towards diseases. India started seeing the advent of malaria. Malaria became pretty big towards the beginning of 2000s, you know, and it's still pretty big in this country, even after 20 years, you know. So that whole shift, while sleep was important, the genesis of disease, which can be called mosquitoes, started becoming bigger, and people started feeling mosquitoes are becoming, that's evolving. So then the brand which picked up in this whole, this thing, then one connect changed on this, shift evolved happened. Goodnight decided to portray mosquitoes and tougher and bigger and hurtier, as we call it, hurtier ho gaye mosquitoes. And hence, how do we give, there was a greater need to protect the family against them. But protection of family remained the core, and all innovation got focused on this. So Goodnight as a brand stayed true to care and protection. That just never changed. This is the lighthouse identity of this brand. But the focus started shifting from pure sleep to assured protection against heavier mosquito infestations. Because that was a big category shift which was happening. And secondly, the brand decided that, okay, I would not be a niche electrical premium player. There are many parts of this country which require protection. We're going to be a mega brand. So it started doing product innovation across formats to drive category penetration. In the formats which existed, so coils existed. This brand was never present in coils, right? The brand had one challenge, how do I disrupt electricals further because there's another innovation which had happened. But that innovation had not taken this insight of mosquitoes are evolving. In this decade, two big bang innovations happened which just changed the fortunes of this brand. One was Goodnight came in 1998 with something called a Maha Jumbo coil. This is the first foray of Goodnight into a mass side of the segment called coils. And the insight there was, which I'm going to show that, that consumers felt in coils that, okay, most coils were at that time small coils, that they don't last more than 4 or 5 hours, while mosquitoes stay from 6 in the night to in the evening till 6 in the morning, or at least 4 or 5 in the morning, you know. So the challenge was, how can we create a coil which gives you all-night protection? And that was the time when this whole word came up, Goodnight Maha Jumbo coil, India's first full-night protection coil came. And the second big innovation, this really made Goodnight into a different kind of a leader, is the big, big R&D work which happened, is an infestation-led control with consumers dual booster mode system happened. Where the insight was that consumers came with a big insight, one of this night, the other was, okay, these electrical machines are there, but there are many times mosquitoes suddenly come in hordes, sometimes they go, they are not in big hordes. Why should my machine be all function the same mode? It's not effective all the time. I want more efficacy, I want less efficacy, it should be in my control. There are also a wastage angle in their mind. Then the challenge was, how can we give control efficacy to consumers? And that led to the birth of this product called dual mode active system, which existed with us till a month back. And that's the last journey I'll tell you. We have killed this product last month, ourselves. It's a 1200 crore product, which has a marketing history of taking a call of getting it out of the market. That's a different, maybe I'll talk about it last. And this propelled GK to a market leadership, these two innovations. So quickly, I'll just run you through the maybe two communications. One thing you should see in this communication, the connect of Goodnight remains very constant.
मच्छर कुत्ते जितना बड़ा
ऐ जुन मत बोल
अच्छा झूठ ये देखो राक्षस का कॉइल
इतना बड़ा
गुड नाइट महा जंबो कॉइल दुनिया का सबसे बड़ा कॉइल सबसे बड़ा कॉइल सबसे बढ़िया नींद
मम्मी कहानी सुना
राक्षस वाली
सो दिस कॉइल इज राक्षस वाली कॉइल यू नो इट्स द होल मेगा नेस व्हिच केम इन एंड देन द फर्स्ट टाइम दिस ब्रांड यूज्ड I don't have. Okay, can you play this ad? This one. If you see, there's an ad in this. Yeah.
अरे दरवाजा बंद कर इस वक्त मच्छर आते हैं.
इस वक्त चैंपियंस भी आते हैं.
सारे मच्छर घुसा दे.
अरे मशीन ऑन तो है.
प्रॉब्लम बच्चों की नहीं मशीन की है जब मच्छर हो ज्यादा तो चाहिए गुड नाइट एडवांस्ड एकमात्र सिस्टम जिसमें है एक्टिव स्विच इसकी दुगनी शक्ति ज्यादा मच्छरों से तुरंत निपटे भले ही खिड़की दरवाजे खुलते रहें
ये तो डोर कीपर से विकेट कीपर बन गए
रोक सिर्फ मच्छरों पर बच्चों पर नहीं गुड नाइट एडवांस्ड
एक्चुअली दिस इज द ओनली टाइम गुड नाइट इज यूज्ड अ सेलिब्रिटी इन इट्स सैड हिस्ट्री जस्ट वन कैंपेन हैज हैपेंड एंड वी नेवर यूज अ सेलिब्रिटी आफ्टर दैट एंड देयर इज अ रीजन आफ्टर दैट वी नेवर यूज सेलिब्रिटी टिल नाउ ओके this was the launch campaign of that double booster active plus system. The first year, it actually, let me tell you, it honestly didn't do very well. It was very surprising for everybody why it didn't do well. And then we find we need to change that. We need to go back to that caring, protection, connect maybe a bit more because we're true to that. That's what we are as a brand about, right? So this was the second decade when two big innovations happened. The first one had fully panned out, the Mahajumbo coil, which gave Goodnight a foothold into the mass segment. Apart from the premium electric segment. And the second one where it started, it came with one of the best innovation this country has ever seen, or maybe the world has seen a double booster system, which has got copied globally by every MNC, the Active Plus system. So this is a summary, two big innovations in that 9 years, shifting from sleep to protecting family against mosquitoes, product innovation across mass and premium both. And the last is obviously this whole insight of mosquitoes evolving, and we need to respond to that. Coming quickly to the last decade of 10, 12 years, this is the year when Goodnight A became market leader. It became market leader across every single format in this country. It became an omni leader that it forayed into all formats. And more than foraying into formats, Goodnight as a brand, riding its connect, riding its identity, and riding its innovation, started creating formats for this category more and more. Many new vectors got blown up. And this is a very different decade. Where we are today. The connect two big insights in this last 10 years which emerged. There's a huge boom of vector-borne diseases this country has seen. This is a decade when chikungunya, dengue, malaria all have taken center stage. We hear of even celebrities dying of dengue. It all became clear dengue is not got to do only with, you know, poor. Even the rich can, you know, it can be fatal for anybody. It's got to do maybe with the climate of a country. It's got maybe with the civil sense of this country. It's got maybe with the hygiene of country. So this is a real serious threat. Led to huge anxiety in mothers. And anxiety primarily from one vulnerability every mom has, kids. Right. Second thing, which one very interesting emotional insight which this brand picked up, is that while there's anxiety happening, moms also see themselves as a very big harbinger and playing a very big role of being creator and protector of happy moments of the family. Those precious moments when family comes together is very important for the mom. And they said, this moment belongs to me. I'm supposed to protect this. And our mosquitoes can actually destroy that moment, right? That's a very big emotional space which emerged. So there are two large criteria context which came. The brand decided to take it in forward in three ways. And this is when brand became truly a thought leader. This is a decade of brand, Goodnight being the omni thought leader. First, we made mother and kids both central within the communication. Some would have mother playing a very critical role. Second, we decided to go away from brand ambassador. We made one attempt. We said, actually, who can be a better brand, given that we are about a care and protection brand? Given the way we talk to consumers like no other mosquito brand talks, everybody is all scaring the hell out of you. We are actually telling you we love you. And that's why this brand is built on around love and care. We said, what best way to assure the mom than actually to get kids with the brand ambassador? And kids are evolving. Kids are becoming smarter, smarter and smarter. A smart kid will bring two things to the brand. One is the cuteness and the love with the brands and will communicate. Second, an assured kid also immediately communicates the efficacy, right? And that's become the true shift of the brand, you know. And the last is, in this decade, we started taking on a role beyond category. We started creating categories. We started educating consumers about many of the vector-borne diseases which are prevalent in this country, which are much beyond just selling the product. And that's a large piece of social work which has happened, which I'm not going to talk about. We are very heavily working with many governments on programs which obviously would not be easily known in public domain, in MP, in UP, where we are working on behavioral change programs, and it is purely a social task that we have taken up, how to help the governments eradicate malaria in this country. And that's one program we did called Subha Bolo Good Night. It's a very interesting creative, that good night is known to be nights. We said, why Subha Bolo? And tell you why this thing happens, Subha Bolo Good Night. So Lighthouse identity remains same, true to care and protection. We evolved from protecting against mosquitoes in the second decade to protecting happy moments. It's a very powerful shift, but it's all in the care and protection zone. And third, this is when we said we'll challenge our market leaders, that leadership agenda is behind us. We have wanted, because the second year of the focus was how do we become leaders. We wanted to just beat the hell out of everybody, to be very honest. Once we achieved that, we said this is a decade now, this category belongs to us. Now our job is to help India eradicate vector-borne diseases, and we can play a small role by creating multiple vectors of this category. And this decade and this journey of Goodnight is all about category creation across multiple vectors. And I'll talk about those vectors. So this is the third decade which is continuing. This is one communication shift which happened after Rani Mukherjee script, which actually changed the whole fortune of this brand.
Push karo aur khush raho.
Good night advance active plus.
Push karo khush raho.
This push karo khush raho communication ran for 5 years in two different avatars. This really built the brand around at happy moments. And obviously this product was a killer and it just took over the category. This campaign, I think, is the Subha Bolo Good Night campaign. Before you play, I just want to talk about it. This one genesis which happened in this India over the last maybe 7-8 years is the advent of dengue, which is different from malaria. And we did a research which told us that 80% of urban Indians, 80% of urban Indians do not know one thing, that dengue is not a evening mosquito. The whole brand protection is still in this country only about evenings to morning 5 o'clock. This is a long agenda. We're not going to even move 5% of it, I can tell you right now. 80% of Indians don't know that there are dengue mosquito bites during the day. So we said, okay, let's make a small effort on educating India about that there's a mosquito which comes in the morning itself. We've done a lot of social work on this, but we did a small campaign which lasted for a year, but at least, and it more than a TV campaign, it's a lot of activation programs we did around this, which is this, this is the one. Yeah. You will play this? I don't know whether this is there. I think I'll have to play it from here. Okay, let me just see.
Huh? Hey, ye subah subah good night kyun on kar raha hai?
Ek bhai, apni behan ke liye itna to kar hi sakta hai.
Hai? Kya?
Arey, main tujhe dengue se bacha raha hu. Subah aane wale machhar aksar dengue kyun hote hain? Pata nahi kya? Come on, yaar.
I didn't know, yaar. Thanks, Golu.
ये तो मेरा फर्स्ट था एंड या डोंट कॉल मी कोल
डेंगू के मच्छर मोस्टली सुबह आते हैं तो इंडिया
सुबह बोलो गुड नाइट
सो this whole campaign called Good Night, Good Habit, you know, which is about habit creation. Right? There are a lot of activation that happened. This is not more a TV campaign, more activation campaign. So this is a stage we started taking. Okay, we'll educate India about the categories itself, you know. This is some of the activations work which happened at that time, very interestingly. But you see, kids became center stage. They are the brand ambassador of this brand. It's the smart young kids who are the advocates of this brand. This is a decade of innovation blast. And again, when I reflect back, I said, wow, in this category where every innovation takes so much of regulatory challenges, we have built categories, multiple vectors. So the first thing which this company did, as a brand we did, in 2009, we said, okay, coils, we've done enough. We picked up, what is the next way to get penetration to category? We realized that there are many people who don't want to use coil because they feel they smoke. So the challenge was to R&D, how can we create a coil which has low smoke? It's not easy. The first coil, and we called it, later on we called it a green Shakti low smoke coil. That happened in 2009. I'll show you the communication of that. Then I think our most, you know, moment of pride which happened, which is this country, I think it's 2013. And that's a journey I partnered around from 2010 onwards. I've been there, right? And I was very happy to see this happen. The brief to this people inside was, India still has huge rural penetration unattended to. India can't afford solutions, right? It can't be transmuted. Coils can tend to break. Electricity is not there in most of India. Even still, it's on paper in many places. How do I give people a solution which is instant, which is easily accessible and transportable through wholesales of this country, and which just comes at 1 rupee? Just 1 rupee. That is the brief. And it obviously has to be safe. It's Goodnight. And we came up with this product called Goodnight Fast Card. It, in 2 years, took rural penetration up by 7%. It's never happened in this category. 2 years, penetration moved by 7%. And everybody else obviously copied us. That's another big innovation. But if you see, these two were all about driving rural penetration. Then we did one innovation, which I'm not going to show you right now, which is premiumization Goodnight Active Plus to something called Express System, which is much more faster. Let me just show you this. This is a Goodnight Green Shakti low smoke coil. Maybe this campaign.
पापा आप पुलिस इंस्पेक्टर हो ना
एसीपी एसीपी
सच में
अरे शहर के बड़े बड़े गुंडे डरते तेरे पापा से
तो फिर ये छोटे छोटे मच्छर क्यों नहीं डरते आपसे
बेटा मच्छर सबसे ज्यादा डरते हैं गुड नाइट ग्रीन शक्ति से
गुड नाइट का 94% नेचुरल ग्रीन शक्ति कॉइल नेचर और एक्टिव मॉलिक्यूल्स की दमदार शक्ति कॉइल के अंदर यानी मच्छर बाहर
तो घर का एसीपी
गुड नाइट
ग्रीन शक्ति अंदर मच्छर बाहर
This is the advent of the fast card, which really made the whole rural penetration change. But if you see, again, kids, mom, or kids and family. That's the whole essence. I don't know.
बेटा, हाथ जोड़ के ना सच्चे दिल से दुआ करो, सब भाग जाएंगे.
Try कर लो.
Good night, advanced fast card. फोल्ड किया जलाया फू किया हो गया इसके टीएफटी मॉलिक्यूल्स फटाक से मच्छरों पे असर करें
देखा सुन लेना भगवान ने
टेबल के नीचे से ना
गुड नाइट एडवांस्ड फास्ट कार्ड फटाक से फुर
एंड आई थिंक वी स्किप दिस वन So these three innovations happened in the first half of this decade. Then we said, what next? While we're doing this job, okay? There's one pivot which I realized, where mothers feel the most weakest. You know, moms, they're protecting kids, they're protecting families, all in home. But the biggest vulnerable moment of this mom is when kids go out of the house, either during schools, dengue is a day mosquito. They're completely vulnerable there. Can you believe it? I mean, they have no protection there. It's a realization, I mean, hey, I do everything to protect in house, but dengue actually strikes in the day. Second is, majority of time kids go to the play in the evenings, which is the highest time of infestation, even of non-dengue mosquitoes. And that's a moment of biggest vulnerability for a mother. So what do we do? This category, there had been a brand of ointments and skin application which has existed for 70, 80 years. But it has never grown the category. Because there's always one challenge, which consumers told us, that hey, I don't like the smell of this product. I don't want it to apply on the skin. Skin irritation. The one big question comes in consumer's mind is, how can you apply a mosquito repellent product on skin? It's a different thing putting it in homes, in corners. Applying on skin on that kids, it's a big one. We came back, okay, how can we actually give a product which protect mosquitoes, much against mosquitoes, even in outdoors, where that category is very small in India, but is not applied on skin. Big challenge. You see how the innovation thing, consumers will never come back to tell you this. This is what we thought. And interestingly, India is the only country in the world where out of home is not developed still. Globally, out of home in Western world is one of the largest formats in mosquito repellency, globally. It's very weak in India. And one of the reasons is because India has never seen innovation in this category. So we came up with this product called Fabric Roll-On. And that's a journey in progress for us. It's a huge categorization job we're doing. It's a progress which is, we are pretty happy, but I think we can do maybe 10 times more than this. It's a habit creation. Because what we're trying to tell people is, use proactively this when you go out. It's a fundamental habit change. But this is an innovation we've done. Second thing which has happened last year was a neem agarbatti. It's India's first 100% agarbatti format to drive rural penetration. And it's non-active based. So that's an interesting piece which happened. And the last one which I'll just talk about, which is making us, which is a system we've created, which maybe I'll just talk last before I show the ad, where we have decided to take a very disruptive call of killing Actives Plus system. We have actually decided to kill something we've created over the last 10 years ourselves. So first quickly, let me tell you about this journey of fabric roll-on.
नहीं नहीं, बाहर बहुत मच्छर हैं।
ग्राउंड पे तो और होंगे।
बेटा मत जा, डेंगू मलेरिया हो गया तो?
जा। और ऐसा सिक्सर मारना कि बॉल गुम हो जाए। गुड नाइट फैब्रिक रोल ऑन, बाहर के मच्छरों को रोको, अपने चैंपियन को नहीं।
कपड़ों पे एक दो तीन चार दो मच्छर फाइटिंग घर के बाहर।
चैंपियन बनना है, बाहर तो जाना पड़ेगा।
गुड नाइट फैब्रिक रोल ऑन।
दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट व्हिच यू अप्लाई ऑन एक्चुअली क्लॉथ्स, यू डोंट हैव टू पुट इट ऑन स्किन एट ऑल। इट्स वी कॉल इट 1 2 3 4 एक दो तीन चार। दिस इज आई थिंक द नीम अगरबत्ती प्राइमरली फॉर रूरल एरियाज।
वरना आपकी ड्राइंग कैसे करूंगी?
हाँ। जल्दी कर बेटी, कमबख्त मच्छर घुसा है।
काट रहे हैं। अब अगले 3 घंटे यहाँ आधा मच्छर भी नहीं दिखेगा।
क्या गारंटी है?
नीम की गारंटी है, गुड नाइट नीम अगरबत्ती। नीम और हल्दी की शक्ति, बड़ी गुड नाइट नीम अगरबत्ती। 3 घंटों तक जले, आधा मच्छर भी न मिले, सिर्फ 15 रुपए में।
In rural area, people still use neem leaves and burn them. So we said, why can't we do something on neem, which has nothing to do with actives? The challenge was, how do you create repellency without actives? So that's the work which R&D did on this, you know. Now this is the last work which I will just say, and then maybe 2 minutes I'll just call it quits here. We realized over the last 10 years what's happened, while we become huge market leaders, our Active Plus system has got copied by every other competitor. Okay, 10 years is a big time to copy it. They copied it off. It took them 5 years to copy, but they copied it. And obviously it's led to pressure on the brand. It obviously, the fact is then the consumers are telling us that mosquito become more stubborn. What do we do next, right? And how do we make it a complete disruption? So what we have come up with, which we just launched 15 days back, okay, and it's still in the process of rolling out, is India's first automatic, and I think what we can claim easily is the world's most powerful liquid vaporizer system, and which is completely automatic. So it's got a smart chip using technology inside it, where the modes that consumers today has to control, they completely change automatically based on infestation levels and timing. So that's a big automatic. It's almost like a matic control which we've given. Plus, we created a technology which, actually, the three briefs maybe I'll just tell you. I think maybe one piece I need to tell you before this thing. There is one piece as a result of this comping of this thing was happening. We realized people have started using multiple solutions in homes. That they're using liquid vaporizer of Goodnight, but they're using agarbatti of somebody else. Or they're using coil of somebody else, or coil of Goodnight also. Because they somewhere felt ek solution kafi nahi hai. Because dengue is much bigger, mosquitoes are becoming much tougher. So the brief we said, okay, can we have the reach in the room of coil, right? Can we have the instancy of aerosols, right? Because aerosols last for 2 hours, but they kill immediately. And can we have the longevity of liquid vaporizer system, all done automatically? It's a crazy brief in that sense. Can we give all the benefits of 3 formats? And it's a call we're taking because we are present in all 3 formats. We are market leader in each of these formats. We have a brand called HIT, which is the market leader brand at 96% share in aerosols. We are the brand. There's nobody else. We are 96% of the category, right? We said, okay, doesn't care. We give a product which is everything rolled into one. And we said we don't want to charge consumers premium. And against our 85 rupees, we just charge them 89. And we launched this product called Goodnight Gold Flash System. What this does is, it actually releases not smoke. It's a technology which it releases vapors, which actually reach in the corners. It has instant repellency effect. And then after a tenure, the machine automatically shifts back to a non-flash mode or the non-vapor mode. And it continues to repeat itself on cycles. So it's a all-in-one product, which is, we believe, maybe the world's most powerful, but definitely India's most powerful and automatic system. And we've taken a call that if we were to do this product, which is so brilliant, and we're not charging consumers premium, then what do we do with the Active Plus system, which is a 1200 crore brand of ours? We said we kill it. Can you believe it? This is a marketing, this would work. I'm convinced, and this will be a marketing case study. Right? You go ahead and say, okay, I'm going to kill my 1200 crore brand. I'm going to sell only this. Because I want single-mindedly focus the entire organization only on this. Because I know that if Active Plus is in 6 crore homes, as long as that exists and this comes, there'll be a much longer shift which will happen. I want to switch the whole country to Gold Flash. And that's the call we've taken 15 days back, right? So this is the Goodnight Gold Flash. And obviously, along with this campaign, we're doing a much larger digital habit change system with the separate creatives. Oh, sorry, this is the one. Okay, yeah, this one. Okay, we can skip this. Yeah, just go into this. Can you play this one? Yeah, this ad.
अरे मशीन से कुछ निकल रहा है
ये गुड नाइट गोल्ड फ्लैश है
इससे फ्लैश वेपर निकल रहे हैं
क्यों क्योंकि मच्छर चाकू की तरह
छुपे रहते हैं
इसीलिए फ्लैश मोड में फ्लैश वेपर्स पुलिस की तरह कोने कोने छुपे डाकू मच्छर फूट के थपा थपा
30 मिनट बाद नॉर्मल मोड में ऑटोमेटिकली
नए डाकू मच्छर आए तो
हर 4 घंटे फ्लैश वेपर्स फिर निकल के थपा थपा
गुड नाइट गोल्ड फ्लैश
छुपे मच्छर को थपा थपा
Actually, this creative is still to go on air. It'll go on air in 10 days' time. It's just gone on air in South, in North and East and West. It's not gone. So this is a new innovation, and there's a huge amount of 6 other creatives which we are building built around that. The intent is to completely switch the category to this all-in-one, one single solution, which is there. And I think I'll skip this piece. I'm done now.
अरे मशीन से कुछ निकल रहा है.
It's not moving here.
ये गुड नाइट गोल्ड फ्लैश.
Yeah. So this is a summary of actually the kind of work we've done in the last decade. This is maybe just a second. Actually, this is a journey of the brand. We are become a dominant market leader in this country. We are 37% share, and the difference between us as the next player is 3 times today. That's why we are the category. And this doesn't include in the HI category, aerosols, which is another brand of ours, which is hit. If I take that, we are a 60% share in the category. But you see the dominance. But this, as I said, this great Spider-Man dialogue, you know, with great power comes great responsibility. And our last decade has been that if this is where we are the category. Our job is no longer about market shares. Our job is about building category and building category across all kinds of formats. India is a country which is in the midst of huge vector-borne diseases. They're not going to go away easily. We want to play our small role in this. And I think that's the whole thought of the brand right now. We are there from one genesis of one electric premium solution of one format. Today, this brand exists across. These are all formats which have been disrupted or created by Goodnight. Every single innovation in the last 30 years except one has been brought to this country by Godrej. Aerosol is hit, and the rest is all Goodnight. So this is where we have created the categories. Obviously, there's a huge amount of brand. We are among, as per brand equity studies, among home care, we are the most loved brands, the number one brand amongst. Some of the iconic brands are there in the top 10, which we have won, and that's a great moment of joy to see how consumers love your brand. We are always among the most admired brands, and that is where we are. We become leaders. Maybe there's one ad in this I wanted to just show, which this one campaign maybe we'll sign off, which we did because it was a very emotional moment for the organization when we became market leaders. Okay, and we became part of every family, this thing. So we did this one campaign for the consumer, which as a thought leader, as a market leader, we did. I want to just show that campaign. It's all about family. This is after that leader slide. Let's see that.
भाई फैमिलीज कई तरह की होती हैं स्मॉल मीडियम लार्ज और कुछ एक्स्ट्रा लार्ज। कुछ फैमिलीज फ्रेंडली होती हैं और कुछ नॉट सो फ्रेंडली। कुछ फैमिलीज परमानेंट होती हैं और कुछ टेम्परेरी। कुछ फैमिलीज नेशनल और कुछ मल्टीनेशनल। कुछ फैमिलीज में पिंकी, रॉकी और स्वीटी होते हैं और कुछ फैमिलीज में
पिंकी,
रॉकी, स्वीटी।
पर फैमिलीज चाहे कितनी भी अलग हो, एक मेंबर तो सेम मिलेगा। गुड नाइट। गुड नाइट को इंडिया का नंबर वन लिक्विड वेपराइजर ब्रांड बनाने के लिए थैंक यू एंड वेलकम टू द फैमिली।
There's one big thank you campaign that we did once we became market leaders. It's one of my favorite campaigns. I think that. So I think that's the way journey of this brand has been. It's built on these three pillars. We've been consistent, and I guess that's where it is. So thank you so much.